I think we need a revival. Friend, you know what? It's time that we get concerned about the lost today. It's time that we get concerned about one another today and want to see each other make it to heaven.
Amen.
And let me tell you what, I'm not jealous of you. I want to see God bless you. I want to see you make it to heaven. And if He gives you a lot of things down here that He don't give me, then hey, may God bless you. But I want to see you get saved, stay saved, and make it to heaven.
Yeah.
How about it? Would there be another? Well, just raise your hand and take it right back down. I don't know who you are. How about it? Would you raise that hand? I don't know who you are, but here's the thing. God knows who you are.
Amen.
You say, well, the old devil's telling me he's doing that because he knows I don't know nobody in here. All I know is, you know what, there's a room full of people. I baptized some of them, but you know what? I still don't know their hearts. Come on now. I know my reading.
Come on.
I can't tell you what's in Frank Gillett's heart. I don't know. But you know what? You give him enough time and out of the abundance of the heart, he'll speak. And you know what? He'll bear a fruit about him. If he's been saved this morning, he'll bear a fruit that I don't know. And he'll bear a witness with my fruit. And hey, let me tell you what, he'll rejoice together.
Come on.
That's what I'm talking about.
Come on.
How about it? Would there be one more? We're going to go on prayer.
Come on.
We got a lot to pray about today. God bless that hand.
Bless the Lord.
I think we need to have church tonight here.
Yeah.
How about it? Would there be another?
Bless.
You know what? I held off starting church last Sunday night because of the fellowship that we had last night. I think we need a revival.
Yeah.
I think revival's in the air.
Yeah.
Come on now. I got plans at the church. I got family coming. I'll bring them to church.
Yeah.
Bring them with you. Everybody pray. You know, we get ready to come up here and go pray. We're going to have church tonight. We're going to see how it goes.
Yeah.
We'll get it out on Facebook. We'll have church tonight. Make some phone calls. Say, hey, guess what? Help preach at church tonight.
Yeah.
6 o'clock. Friend, you know what? There's a lot we need to pray for. There are people. Now, let me tell you this. Let me throw something on your shoulder, say. There are people dying and going to a devil's hell because you're not doing your job.
Come on.
What's your job, preacher? No, it ain't. There's people dying and going to hell because you know what? We don't say, hey, why don't you come pray for me? I'm going to say this, and I promise you, there's a young man on my heart today. I've been trying to break a chain with him. At first, he told me he didn't believe in God. Then I asked him a very important question after that about a personal situation in his life.
Yeah, come on.
He said, oh, no, no, I believe they went to heaven. I said, well, if you believe there's a heaven, you have to believe there's a God. He said, well, I won't rule it out yet.
Yeah.
Friend, we have people today because we refuse to witness for the Lord.
Come on. Yeah, come
on. I don't know whether we're ashamed of it, whether we just get complacent around friends, and we'd rather talk about the UK Wildcats and the McDonald's Candy Hornets. We'd rather talk about the weather and the tornado that passed through, but we fail to mention the Lord.
Come on.
Oh, that weighs heavy on your shoulders? Good. I've done my job.
Yeah.
I've done my job. But there's a job that we got to do.
Come on.
You know what? If we get up around this altar, I want you to pray. Pray for the service that we're going to have tonight. Pray for the service. Here, pray for the long hands that was raised. That's your obligation today. Come on, get up around this altar.
Paul.
Everybody, come on.
I need anointed for my sister.